Oh my goodness, are we ready for a party? Oh my. Is it Wednesday? What day is it today? This is Ann Klemmer and Stamper from stamperdog.com. Let's get started.
Stamper, come.
Are you a good boy? He let me catch him today. Oh, look at he needs his face wash. That's the worst I've seen it. It must be allergies. Oh my goodness. Hey, Stamper. Oh yeah, we should have washed your face. Oh. So hey, I know who was here first today, and I thought that it was Deb Bradford, but it was Barbara Parker. I don't know how she pulls that off. She goes in there and comments even before we get started over there. And how does that work? So, you know, I'm just going to give props to both of them because, hey, they deserve it. And I'm so glad that you made time in your busy day or really boring day. I said that word. Anyway, you came and you showed up, and you know, I don't know what we're going to do. Well, it's in here, but let's see if we can get started, because my main thing, whether I finish a card or not, and those of you who hang around here know that most of the time I do not finish the card, because really all I want to do is spend time with you and inspire you to go make a card. And if that works, hey, you guys keep showing up, so it must. So if you have never been here before, I'm Ann Klemmer, and that was my dog. Yeah, his name really is Stamper. And if you at some time you find anything helpful for you, hey, make sure that you like and subscribe, because we'd love to have you back. Oh, Kevin's up there in Puget Sound. Okay, I've got to ask you, Kevin, is it boating weather? Because my dad, you know, when he was alive, he did not like to do anything between Memorial Day and Labor Day other than get with his friends and go out on their boats. I mean, that was just something to do. So, oh yeah, the rockets blasting off today. You know, I asked them to do that right at the same time that I was going off, but I guess they're a little delayed, yeah? Oh, we had such fun yesterday. Yeah, it's cough drop. Sorry, I'm not eating. And the dog is here cleaning my ankles as he usually does. And see, look at, see, now we have the weather report from Puget Sound. Now, as far as the rest of you are concerned, it is raining up there. They all have their umbrellas out and they don't want you to move there, okay? You know, it's bad because, well, I never felt this way, but I know that years ago, and they probably still feel like that, you know, they think, oh, those Californians are moving up here, and I almost want to change my license plate if I ever drive home. That's why I always rent a car. So anyway, I've got to get this done today, so it will for sure be on the website tomorrow. I have, Kevin, just for you, I have gone and finished the foil card, but I don't want to show the exact finishing of it because it's not quite what you think I would have done. But I want to make sure that person receives it yet before I do, because they're on this call. Well, whatever you want to call this. Yeah, yesterday we were talking about maybe, you know, what would we call something for my clients so that we could have a private group? And you came up with some great ideas. In fact, I got one this morning that said "Great Stampers, Great Danes." Only it should be Great Dames. But then, not all my clients are women. It's 99.4%. Yeah. So I thought, even though it's a negative thing, I thought Stampers Dog Pound. And especially if it has a welcome sign there, right? Yeah. Yeah, go to the pound, you know. Dog House was good, but it just doesn't flow like Dog Pound. Yeah. And we can get in some real trouble. Now, I can finally probably tell you that if you were thinking about joining my team, you definitely want to do it next week. Normally, you know, actually the right time to do it, don't wait for a special, just go do it. I mean, when I signed up, it was a special and I waited till the last day, as many of us do, right? And they had to fax my stuff in and I got this VHS tape. Remember, this is 21 years ago. I got a VHS tape that I don't know if I've ever seen it all the way through because it was about scrapbooking. Oh, launch in 29 minutes. Okay. Someone tell Kathy and Stamper what they're launching. I just saw something briefly that they're launching for this someone to the space station from a certain vantage point for the first time since 1981. Is that it? Something like that. I didn't read it. I just saw the pictures. You know, yeah. Stamper, what are you doing? He's sniffing his bed. I wonder if his favorite human went. Yeah, look at that. Stamper's rescue group. Yeah. So anyway, yeah. I have been to in Huntsville, Alabama. Is it Huntsville? They have a space camp there with the like the Challenger, but not the Challenger, but you know, those kind of rockets. And so, yeah. So anyway, there's a couple things we're going to try today. And one of the things I wanted to show you, now this will probably go away because I haven't seen the new adhesive that we have, right? But when I wear my Stampin' Up apron, I have one of these right on my apron, and it's really great to have. In fact, on TV, the hosts, that's the thing that they wanted to look at. And you can get this. This is a name badge holder. You could probably get this at Staples. You could get it at, you know, they come in different colors, but they have this on them. And they have this, which, you know, might not attract you. You know, remember I told you I like to go to IKEA with those people who have vision, you know, more vision than I have. And so I'm going to show you how we'll see how it goes because, we'll see how it goes. Because it's not that hard to do, but you buy one of these and you might have to buy three at a time and you pull it out and you might have to have some, you know, I'm not going to say talent, but the thing is you take this strip. Oh golly, I'm doing black against black. Hold on one second. Let me get some fresh curry out here. That'll help. And turn up the, how about if I turn up the lights here and create more shadows? Okay, so all you do is hold that and put it, see, in between underneath this so that this little button or whatever is left over is outside and that's outside. See, like that? Okay. I don't have a free hand to go and make it go closer, so, well, hold on, let's see. There you go. This is a very old snail adhesive. And then you take this and, whoa, and put it in there. See, this is the part that if nobody's watching, it goes in really, there you go. And then you just clip that to your clothes, and there it is. So even though that's not really like an organizing your room tip, that is definitely a tip that I can use. How about you? You don't have to be a demonstrator. You could, you know, like I could, let's see. I could like clip it, not to my necklace, that's for sure. See, I can clip it right there. Not with a mic. It's really hard with a mic, right? And then just pull it out. And you always know where it is. So when I go to these big card swaps where we all make cards, I always have one of these on because I never have to reach around where is my adhesive. Now, I'm thinking it will work on the new one, but until you're done with your snail, hey, there it is. Another thing I wanted to talk about, we talked about how we put these together, you know, the cling stamps, right? And some of you said that you put them into this, but I hope you don't attach this part to here because it makes it really hard to get them out without disturbing the edge of the stamp. That's the only thing I'm concerned about. If you want to go and, you know, the other thing you could do is leave this edge on here, right? And then you know that this one goes right there, if you're concerned about that, because I did get caught out once. But for the most part, if I just go and say, oh, there's 8 stamps, let me count 8. Boom, done. So, but don't attach this to that. Now, we did talk about, or we did mention, taking your old cling stamps. Why does that not want to give me any light here? Hold on, let's see. I'm hoping that's better. Oh, I'd like to think that's a little bit better, but it's gonna shine in my eyes. But you don't care if the light's in my eyes, right? see, that makes this side brighter than this side. You're gonna have to turn the lights up. Oh, wow. Yeah, I understand, Kim, that they're not going to be taken off for another half hour, so I'll hurry. But I'm keeping this one. If you're thinking I'm going to sell this in the sale the first Friday, well, no, that would be a no. Yeah, yesterday we went a little over an hour, and usually I like to keep these to 30 to 45 minutes, and usually 45 minutes is about... Yeah, that's about as much trouble as I can get into. But we talked about making these a little bit clingier, right? And I know I have this, and I know I'm going to sell this because I already replaced it. But let's see. Hold on. Now, I did bring, you know, my little... Here, all I had to do was reach back. And there's my stuff. I love it. I love it. I'm going to cut off. I don't even think I need that much. I think if I just cut off the two corners, because make sure that I'm not cutting off anything over here. Because some of you have already done this. In fact, you're the ones that gave me the idea. I love this set too. And it's going away. And if you think you want it, get it now, because it's going to be one of those that people are going to say, oh, you didn't buy it early, so here, let me go and take a notch out of your wallet. Yep. So I'm going to put, yeah. Okay, here's the hardest thing I'm going to do today. Get that to open up. So I'm taking this, and this is sticky. Well, which side's the right side? Hold on. Yeah, okay. I'm going to put it... No. You don't need a lot, from what I understand. And I'm going to stick that on there, like that. I need to save up for another light. Nope, that doesn't want to peel. Somebody help me here. You know me, I go and do things for you, and it's all a science experiment until something goes wrong. I'm just trying to... Ooh. Hey, Nancy, I don't know if you were here yesterday, but we did show your card. Beautiful. There it is. See, if you look really close, you can see... Just the edges. There it is. See it? That's where I put it. So, I mean, it's not impossible. And then I'm going to do it up here, too. So you take it. Yep, that's sticky, all right. And I honestly don't know what's going to be more sticky. Oop, don't stick it to that. And what I'm going to tell you is when you do this, just pay attention to which side the printing is. Like this thicker side is actually the side that you want to have against the stamp. So I may have done this wrong, but you'll forgive me. But I don't think I did that second one wrong. See? There. So now we're going to get a... Oops, sorry, it's going to be a dirty one. Does it fit on this? No, I guess I did have... Okay. See, it's still not very far over there. I know it fits on this one. You notice that I go and put my... Isn't that lovely? Okay, so here Nita, who knows all, believe me, anytime I take a clear mount set to use, I convert it to cling before I put it away. So anytime she takes an old one out, and it's super easy, works great when you cut your cling off, stick it to a clear block, and then peel off the top and turn the block over and press it onto the stamp. Okay, well, okay, do it like she said. But this actually is working, and look at when I go to pull it off. Whoa, look at, see, I did the wrong side. Do it the way Nita said. Do it the way Nita said, because if you do it the wrong way, it's going to stick to the, well, hey, you know what? I'll clean that off later. Do it opposite the way I said. And that's why it's always good to watch the whole program. Love it. So, I have this idea, and I have to ask Mr. Clemmer to help me. Hold on one second, you don't want to listen to this. Okay, so there, I did that. And now I'm going to get a piece of shimmery white paper, cardstock, whatever you want to call it. First thing I do when I don't know about you, but the first thing I do whenever I get something out, I go and I cut it in half. Makes it a whole lot easier to go and deal with it, right? Now, you could do this in Bumblebee. Because Bumblebee's very close to this. And yes, that's what I was getting. Yes, this is not out yet. You'll be able to go and buy it. But if you have some, you know, a new stamp set, there's no reason why. Oh! See, now aren't you glad I didn't cancel for today? So I need a graduation card, right? I need a graduation card. And here's something from my belief system, which really has nothing to do with anything else, is that, you know, we're feeling really bad for the graduates. And yeah, kind of, but for me personally, my graduation day from high school, since I didn't ever graduate from anything else, it was kind of anticlimactic. Afterwards, I was like, so what do we do now, right? And that's just because of the way things were at the time, right? Yeah. So, you know, I don't know how it is for other graduates. I know that when our daughter graduated from high school, we had my parents fly down. You know, we had a little thing for her. And, you know, you're thinking the high school graduates probably want to go and sneak off and have a party with their friends, right? When I graduated, they had an all-nighter. And by the time 5 o'clock rolled around, I was so tired. I was like, can I go home now? No, you got to wait till 7, you know. So, I know from my granddaughter's high school graduation, I flew out, and all of her grandparents flew out to Missouri. No, it's a printed piece of... this is not good. And then we had a big party there, but I think she disappeared at some point. So here's the thing about the graduations, you know, and by the way, when our daughter got her 4-year degree and her master's, she didn't walk for, because she did that online. But her PhD, we flew up for that too, and we flew down for her 4-year degree. So yeah, you know, when you're older, I think it means even more. But anyway, back to this thing. I think if we approach it from, well, at least you'll have a graduation that's unique. It's different from anybody else's graduation. And because most of them are, you put the robe on, you go walk across stage, you know, and maybe you'll get some honors, maybe you'll get a scholarship. But look it. People have drive-bys, people have parties, they, you know, you have John Krasinski doing weird things on Some Good News. Yeah, gotta watch that. So back to this, yeah. Now, I did get my Memento ink out, because the colors, the good thing about doing a graduation card, the good thing about being a stamper, a card maker, is that you can make these any color you want. And I have an idea for this. You know, like I usually do. Yeah, baby. And I love shimmery white cardstock. It might seem expensive, but no. I hope I did that. And we don't have brilliant blue for a blend. So I'm gonna see. And we don't have crushed curry for a blend. But this is Dark Daffodil Delight. We'll see how that is. And of course, I could use a marker, but that would just seem so foreign to me. So let's see, because, you know, and Pineapple Parade, or Pineapple, whatever it is that's going away. I mean, she said that the colors were blue and yellow. See, now this is more of a blue and gold. This is blue and yellow. That's the pineapple, and... okay, Beverly says she's been using temporary adhesive on her stamps. That's an idea. But since this stuff, you know, I mean, you buy sheets, you're good. Let me go get I think I did get pineapple out here. You know, I can't read with these glasses. This is the dark pineapple. Let me get up. I'm just going to go here. That does look yellow. Well, since she said yellow, maybe I'll just do it in yellow. Let's see where... this is the Light Daffodil Delight. Yeah, that's it. Thank you. I really like that better. And this should be the Dark Daffodil Delight. There's nothing saying that you cannot go and mix them. Whoa! Way different. Dark Daffodil Delight, Light Daffodil. Pineapple Punch. I'm reading these upside down. You notice that. Wow. Dark Daffodil Delight's almost like crushed curry. What do you think? This looks cream under red light. Okay, this is light. And this is always a good thing to do. Okay. There. Keep them all together here. I'm going to go over this. I'm going to take my glasses off for this. I'm going to go over it with... And I'm not going to do the hat because I'm going to cut a square and make that into a... Boy, you really can't tell that that's... I'm going to cut a square and put that over it, so... Boy, I don't even have to go in... Boy, is that even writing? Yeah, it is. Okay. You notice I, you know, there's really no right or wrong way. Connie Hobbs just did something I want to know about. Okay, thank you, Connie. Here, I'll make that a little bit closer for you. Yeah, I can see where, see, it's a slightly different color. This blends a little bit more than, I'm not a big yellow fan. I'm just putting this dark where I, yeah, okay. Now this is light Night of Navy. Yeah, we'll see how that is. Boy, that's really bright now. Ooh. But it creates let's see how light this is because, yeah. That, look how light that is. Yeah, okay. But is it going to go with this? Close enough, yeah. At least in mine. Okay, so Laura says she's got a chart where she blended all the colors. Yeah, you know, I could do that. Gonna give her a little bit of, this would probably be smarter to do with the fine point. Boy, tornado. You know, people worry about those earthquakes in California. There's always something, right? There's always something. And I'm going, but it, yeah. At least they don't happen as much. Anyway, okay, so there's blue and yellow. Yep, there's blue and yellow, and that's gonna be the color of her stuff. I'll color her, well, you know, let's see. I'm looking at these and, yeah. Wow, let's make her gray. Okay, so there's bronze. I use that a lot, which is probably more true to form. Ivory. Thing about the color chart, I like to see, that's a good idea. I have dog hair. It's a good idea, but I like to see them side by side so I can kind of get an idea what... Okay, here we have light crumb cake. Let's go over here. Yeah, that looks a little bit more unnatural. Like if somebody... Yeah, and that... Oh, wow, what was that? Oh, light smoky slate. Yeah, that's how I'm going to color everybody. I think that's more for Halloween. Those two colors really would work well for Halloween. Okay, so... Huh. I wish I could go somewhere in between that and that. You know, and I would... You know, that's for another day. See, yeah, that's the other thing. I always have the markers with me, or the blends with me, but I don't always know where other little things are. And by the way, Gladys, they're great for skin tones. And if you have a larger piece there, then you could probably get a more accurate color. But see, look how small these are. You know, it's like, here, I'm going to try on the foot because I might not. See, when you put it on there, that actually looks darker anyway. Boy, this light. I don't want to, like, get it in the picture. Nope. Boy, that makes it really light. How it looks to me and how it looks to you. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do, is put the mortarboard on her head. And I have a video on YouTube somewhere, and what I can do is, for those of you who are watching this on a replay or on YouTube, I can go and put a link at the end of this once it's processed by YouTube, and that might make it a little bit lighter. See, I think that makes it too dark. And it shows you how to cut a mortarboard out of cardstock. So, yeah. Ah, but wait. Like I said, that foot might not even be in there, but that really almost looks, that doesn't look too dark. So maybe I'll just go with that. I could go with the color lifter, but then I don't know. I don't know about that. So I put this on first, and then I put, wow, she's got a big toe on her. yeah, that's what I get for using that blender side. Okay, and then, and I'm trying not to go up to the top because I want her to go and have a little shine on it. I don't know if that last part makes a difference or not. It's really, it's more of a watercolor thing. We wouldn't all want to look alike, right? That would just be awfully boring. I may be doing this all for naught, because wait till you see what I'm going to do with it. No, that's not it. She graduated with all A's, I think. Her mother's very smart. This looks a little smudgy. See, sometimes you can make things just a little bit darker just putting the same color over the bottom, and then it looks darker on my screen. I'm like going, oh wow. But of course I can move in over here and see what does it look like to you. So there. So the idea I had I think I know where I put them. See, this is one thing that you can do. The hand lettered prose, yeah, you want to get that because that's a really nice font, and you can go and make the word grad, make the word, but there's no numbers in it, right? But see, this is going to have this in here. Look at my scissors, were right there. I cut a few of these. Now, what they tell you when you get this, and this is going away the end of the catalog as well, but what they tell you when you get this is that, you know, to print out the whole thing and then just go across here and go across here and cut it, right? Well, the only thing with that is maybe you don't want all of those. So for me, what worked was that I used that little cut that you know, bring this up, bring it up full size on your screen, and then use the, you know, where you can clip a part of your screen. And so you can put, just clip that and put it into a Word document, and then you can go and see, because all I wanted was the toilet paper. I didn't want everything. And I am going to want these, right? Those are ones I wanted. So that's one way that you can get even more out of it by wasting less paper. Yeah. So here, I'm going to need two of these. And what I'm going to do with the 2020, but these are my O's. Now, in a perfect world, I would have had these cut out. But remember, I'm just trying to inspire you. Now, if you notice, what I'm doing here is you go and turn the... turn the cardstock when you're cutting. Now, many of you probably knew that, but in just in case you didn't, I hope that's helpful, because someone had to tell me, and I can tell you exactly the person who did. See, now I clipped into that just a little bit. Now I'm going to, I've shown some of the, this is a Master Stamper thing, but hold on. I don't want to get this too close because it's going to, if you take a regular marker, hold it like this, right? And just go along the edge. Then you're going to be hiding a lot of that anywhere where you may have trimmed a little bit wide or a little bit short. See? Like that. Insert music here. Hey, did you like the new... I had new music before we started. Those of you on YouTube don't get it. I only... it's so that I can start all the things right. Now, this is where it gets hard. Do you ever have that spot where it's like, well, golly, I have to go like this because, you know, for me, it, to go bend into that corner is just not reasonable. And there you go. And now I'm going to put it on the bottom. I would have waited, but you know how I have to like tell you things when I think about them, because otherwise you might not, I might not tell you. So that's a little trick why you always want to have a black marker around. Golly, that light is so bothering me. So I'll give you an idea where we're going with this. Let me go and, oh yeah, hey, while we're at this, let me go and, you know, I talked about my In Color Club and I talked about Sweet Treats a little bit, and I'm looking for a dye, if you want to know the truth. Woo, that wasn't a good spot to sit, or to walk into. If you want to get all of the new In Colors, then, you know, these stars were not where I thought they were going to be. If you want to get all the new In Colors, you want to get them kind of on a payment plan, this is the way to get them. You get all those things listed on the right every month in your package. Now, where it's got the asterisk by the blends combo, that's because there is no Bumblebee blends combo. Right? And so you'll definitely want to, golly, there is no star. I'm not liking that. I had them and I kept moving them, and now it's like, where'd they go? Anyway, and then, so then, you know, and then I order them the beginning of the month, and as soon as they come in, then I mail it to you. You have everything, 10 yards, not five, not two, but 10 yards, a full package of the 12 ribbon. You get a marker in that color. I'm probably not starting off with cinnamon cider and bumblebee because those are a little bit lower in lower in inventory. So if you want to just go buy everything on your own, yeah, I would. You might want to get those first. I'm not sure because I think they're out until June. Not sure. And then you'll get all the enamel dots in that color. Then you'll get all the 6x6 designer paper in that color. You won't have colors that you're not going to have yet. You're going to get them all together. So that is a great way to do it. And I know that Nettie and Marcy, you know, asked about from the very beginning, because, you know, there's things that I do, and like the sweet treats. Well, you know, I can't even show you the sweet treats, but make sure that you get on my mailing list, because as soon as I'm done with this, I've already told the previous sweet treat participants, and they've had their chance to be first in line. And then and what the sweet treats are, it's almost everything. It's almost everything that's new in the catalog. Almost everything. Like things that don't travel well, like the jar, little things for the shaker cards. You know, they don't travel well twice. They'll travel well once when you send it to someone in a padded envelope, but I don't want it, you know what I mean? I want, and like the really fine laser cut papers, stuff like that, it doesn't travel well, or we can't divide it well, then those are the things that aren't in there, but it's all on the list. And golly, Kay, you saw that this morning. Do you remember? It was like 236 things, or you can just get just the designer series paper. So go ahead and you can check the blog out if I ever makes it to the blog, because the next set of people to get it are my newsletter readers. And if you just, you know, if you're on YouTube, there will be a button up in that corner, right? And then at some point during this, and then and I'm sure there's a link below, and but you can also go to this stampery.com/mail. Yeah, there you go. I'm still cutting these. Yeah. So hey, and they're going to have a great little they're going to have a great special coming up in June. You know, I started to talk about that, where you get to pick a bundle, any bundle, to add to your starter kit for the same price. So the starter kit is $99 and free shipping, and they only charge you tax. So if you're in Oregon where they don't have sales tax, you know, you make out like a bandit. And then you pick out $125 worth of items for $99. And then you add on to, after you've picked that out, then you're going to go, and actually it's probably the first thing you pick out is the any bundle you want. And that's the bundle with the dies, or the, and those things run like about $50. So some of them do. That's right. That's right. Now, see, I didn't do as well on this, right? I didn't do it right there. I mean, now this is that exact part of my personality coming out. Yeah. And so I'm just going to take this and just make sure that it's on its a slant. You don't want to like dip it in like this. You want it to be perpendicular. Teachers, is that the right word? Perpendicular to it. Yeah. But remember, they're going to look at this as O's. They're going to look at that like O's. And so, yeah. Now, I'm going to more tell you how this is going to go together. And tomorrow, you can look and see exactly how it's going to go together. But I got to find my other roll of toilet paper. Well, here it is. See, look at, aren't those great O's? Yeah, baby. And let me go and, well, this is sparkly. I have tons of small pieces of, it won't be this small. But I got that set and I accidentally bought two of them. And it's right, now I remember. Oh, did I put it back up here? No, yeah, I did. This is a great set to get because you have it for all of the, it's gonna be in the new catalog and it's gonna be in the old catalog. But look it, you can make anything, anything. To a wonderful, happy, for a special, on your, you're the, and then, like, best nephew, best father-in-law, granddaughter, grand, you know, and then, see, look at, they've got the, all this. So, of course, you know, is there anything that I want on here? Maybe not the words, but in, unless I wanted to say you're the best, right? You're the best, right? But here, if I take the two, oh, right, and I'm gonna go a 2-0, right? Well, there's two there, 2005. Yeah, it's a really late it's a really late graduation card, right? And then when I get the, as soon as I get off of here, I'm gonna find where those, that star die is, because I know I have it. I just know I have it, and it's not where it's supposed to be, and it's not where else it could be. And then I'm going to cut this out where the star is part of this, right? There you go. I believe for the I've slept since then, right? And I was up late last night just because it's a big spreadsheet to go and do the sweet treats. You get some of everything. Now, what we have changed to try to keep the prices down is that we have gone and for the 12 by 12 pieces, you get a 4 by 6 piece, right? So that's easy to where you could cut it in half and do a 4 by 3 piece on your card. You can do two of those, or you can just cut it down to where it's 4 by 5 1/4, so it's a whole background. But that way we can get more out and we don't have to charge you as much. Then the 6 by 6 ones, yeah, you get the full size 6 by 6 of those. And so I believe it's $35.95. It's somewhere between $35 and $37 for all of the designer series papers. But if you want like the extra special glimmer papers that are coming out, and all of the, there's 23 yards of ribbon, there's 23 yards of ribbon, there's all of the buttons. The only thing we didn't do was the wood, because the wood is too hard to go and divide up evenly. So and you kind of got an idea from look at what it is. Yeah. And so anyway, that I believe is $69.95, and then you, of course we add the priority shipping, because you know Uncle Sam's got to keep those guys in blue rolling. So there you go, that's what it, yeah, there was a, hold on, boy, did I get in on part of this. Yeah, look at this. Yeah, oh yeah, back on that color club. Yeah, you get the blends. I mean, isn't that great? There's an old wood set that had those stamps. Are you talking about the one that I'm using now, Kay? Because this, yeah, maybe it did. It might have, you know, because we switched over. Oh, thank you. I knew it was somewhere around there. Yeah, and I send those in a regular priority envelope, but when you get the deluxe package, the all package for $69.95, I send it in a padded priority envelope, because I try to make things so that where it's affordable for you and it's easy for me, and it comes in the you know, we want everything to get there in a nice, pristine way. So they're, you know, they're packaged really nicely. And if you're interested in that, make sure that you get on my email list so that we can send you something. I mean, you know, like don't snooze on this. Hey, pup.
Yeah. Oh, you poor thing.
Yeah, that's gotta be, oh my goodness, there's a little bag. Yeah, we save those so that we could put all the little things in there. Anyway, I'm really glad that you hung out with us today, and I hope that you'll make time to hang out with us tomorrow. You just never know what I'm going to get up to. Tomorrow I might actually even finish the card, or else we'll do Throwback Thursday and look at some old stuff and anything to inspire us, because what's most important is that you get out there and go make something. Yes, make something. You know, like Nike says, just do it. This is Ann Clever and Stamper from stamperdog.com, where we're trying to put a little ink, paper, and fun.
Give me a Y, give me an E, give me a yeah!
Into your day.